In this video, I'm going to take you through the energy monitoring I've set up in my home assistant. Stay tuned. Hi, John here, welcome. I promised this video for a while, but I've been sort of tinkering with my setup and now I'm at a stage where I'm okay with it. I guess like most things, it's evolving and it'll change over time. But as I record this, this is currently my setup. So I'm in Home Assistant. This is our main screen, as it were, our default dashboard, which gives you a view of all of the main rooms in the house and the entities within those rooms, so lights, smart switches, and so on. Over on the left-hand side, there's a couple of actions or automations, more accurately, which a good night, as you can well imagine, turns off all lights and anything else downstairs and turns on upstairs lights, and then the good night off, which is the opposite of that, just in case you press it by mistake. The post arrived I've already talked about previously, which is a trigger for our post box, and that tells us when we've got post because we can't see it and we don't have a letterbox in our front door. And then the two below are our location devices for our iPhones, telling us when we're home or not home. This screen, or this dashboard, is a view of all our smart plugs. So smart plugs on the left and battery percentage on the right for any things like motion detectors and what have you. You can toggle them on and off from here as well. So you just click on the little on off button, and as you'll see there, it'll move from being on or off. Moving along to the next dashboard, this is the energy monitoring. And this I've sort of combined because previously the weather and the forecast and the radar view was on the home page, but I've moved it onto this page. But I guess primarily we're interested in the first two blocks. These use the myenergi integration built into Home Assistant. So I shall show you that towards the end of the video on how to pull that in if you haven't already got it. That looks at the zappi, the harvi, or two harvis in my case, the hub, and also the eddi. So they're the things that are monitoring there. The first one is solar generation today, so that's an accumulative for the day, and the rest are actuals. Well, I say they're actuals, it polls the myenergi API every 30 seconds. So our home usage now 2.584 watts or 2.5 kilowatt. The split between the two arrays, because I've got a CT clamp on each of the arrays, so I'm able to split them out. So the 3.8 array actual, 2.7 at the moment, and then the 2.2 array was 1.7. Import today, which is actually an accumulative, so rather than an actual. And then export today, which again is an accumulative rather than an actual. And then at the bottom, it's got our Powerwall percentage, state of charge, and our battery, what's actually happening with the battery, whether it's importing or exporting. So as you can see there, it's currently exporting 2.2. Eddi is in the next column, and what's its status, and how much green energy is being stored, and how much in this current session is being consumed or used, or is heating hot water, if you like. The zappi next to it allows us to change the mode, so I can change that from here if I want to. It tells me its current status, what green energy has been used today to charge the car, and in a session between plugging it in and unplugging it, how much in total. And then over on the final side is the forecast. So on any one of these main options, for instance, the Powerwall charge, if I click on that, it brings me up a little mini chart or history. So I can hover on that and see what's happening over the last few hours. Same with any of them, grid export, for instance, is an example here. And you can click on those and go into an expanded history if you wanted to. We've also got built in to Home Assistant the energy tab, and that tracks the Powerwall in this particular case. So the energy usage in the top panel shows you, if I slide along here, everything that's happened today. So in hourly slots, so again this is historic rather than actual, and accumulative over on the right hand side in that sort of bubble chart in the top right hand corner there. So below that we've got solar production, and again that's in hourly blocks. The dotted line is the solar forecast utility that's also included in my setup. It gives an idea of what we're likely to generate every hour, and that's fairly accurate actually. I'm quite impressed with that. Over on the energy distribution graph, again that's accumulative for the day. If you click on the grid option, that then takes you out to the electricity map to give you an indication for your location or GB, exactly what's happening and what is the composition of electricity currently being generated in the UK, which is quite interesting, and how red or green it is depending on where it comes from. There's carbon intensity. You can see also the interconnectors there are live, whether they're importing or exporting. And then the three dials underneath allow you to look at your net consumption. And as it says there, the needle's in purple, you've returned more energy to the grid than you've used. If it's in blue, you've consumed more energy from the grid than you've returned. The self-consumption of solar energy is self-explanatory, how much you've used. Higher the number, the better. And then the non-fossil fuel energy consumed, again, is similar sort of thing, how much energy consumed for your home was generated from non-fossil fuels. The higher number, the better. And then you can scroll down, then it gives you the sources for the data above it. So as I said earlier, it's all Powerwall data. And you can also add additional devices as well, which I don't find particularly useful on this tab and have since removed them since recording this. Depends on which devices you've got in your setup, whether you may find that useful or not. If you want to add these, go into settings, devices and services. And then I've already got mine added here, which is the myenergi option. So down at the bottom here, you click add, type myenergi, choose it from the list, and then you'll need the serial number from your hub, and then you'll need your API key. And if you're not familiar with how to do that, if you look here in the configuration in GitHub, it'll tell you exactly how to create, I'm just going to scroll down, how to create your API key. So that's done here, it's very straightforward. I created mine, it generates one for you, and then you can plug it in there, click submit, and it will then appear. And then you'll have your devices listed. So I've got the eddi, as I said earlier, the two Harvis, the hub, and the Zappi. And that gives you a whole raft of entities. So just go back and do it a different way just to show you the 49 entities. Just filter out. So this is just the myenergi ones. So you can see there's a whole load here which I'm not using. I'll just scroll through them. So CT internal load today, device priority, consumed during session. This is all for the eddi. Energy used today, green energy used today, heater priority, CT load internal, CT2 not being used on my setup, and what I guess actually operating mode is, and then internal load CTE, seeing its status, temperature, tank 1, tank 2, and then onto the Harvi, which is all your CT clips. So AC battery, our generation for one of our PV arrays, And then we've also got a second Harvi, which has the other CT generation clamp for the other array. Also a grid array, CT clamp. So again, not all of these are necessarily useful. As you can see there, there's a lot of entities, 49 in fact in my case, that you can hook into and show on your dashboard. And quite simply, your dashboard, go back to the dashboard, edit the dashboard, edit here, and then you can add your entities however you particularly want. You just find it, just want an entity. You can either have multiple entities or a single card. And let's have a look at myenergi. Just put one in for you, just to show you. Let's find one that's status there for the eddy. So it's currently diverting. Save and it'll appear on there, which obviously duplicated from over here, but you get the idea. So that's your options for home energy monitoring. And obviously you can add as many or as few as you like. There's no rights or wrongs, it's whatever you particularly want to do. Anyway, that's all I wanted to show you. So any questions, drop down below and I will pick them up in the comments section. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Take care.